Okay, so we'll take this from bar one.
Well, thank you guys for coming here. Tom Newman, the composer on Finding Nemo and now Finding Dory, and Bill Bernstein is the music editor. We are here to review some of the tracks from the score. We've chosen these particular tracks because they seem to encapsulate thematically the movie and what you've discovered, I guess. Let's delve into it.
Okay, what would you like to start
with? Let's start with Finding Dory, yeah.
We can start with, there's some ambient sounds that have some kind of implied pulsation. Right. This, the piano phrase, is a phrase in 5-4.
4 and 5, 1, 2, and 3, and 4, and 5, 1, 2.
Which I don't know why seemed like Dory-ish, that it wasn't in a straight
that's
dupometer.
That's the hopeful part of it, the joyful part, right?
That's right. I think I wrote long before we started working.
It's funny.
And I thought it was something was emblematic about it.
For me, because I think you were evoking a journey, it has a once upon a time quality to it. Which works great as leading you into like the beginning of a larger story.
Right.
And maybe because you were dealing with sort of the core wound of Dory, that it worked as her theme.
Right, that it had a certain amount of quirky joyousness or something, and it had a kind of bounce.
The use of these abstract vocals, that's sort of new for you, right?
Yeah, the human sleigh bells. Just as
so
the sense of joyousness, it's arpeggiated, so it has this kind of, kind of buzziness to it.
It kind of carries that childlike spirit that you just know is in Dory.
Right, that despite circumstances, yes, there's joy and a true sense of loving life. We also had a conversation about where it should go out, because I thought it should go all the way out to the end of this pan down with pulsation, but you really wanted the sounds of the empty ocean to be there way ahead of little Dory saying,
"Hello."
The same piece has a different application at the end of the movie now.
That's right. We go to a flashback, and then this opening bit of music returns as a kind of a bookend.
But this time, it's a goodbye. It's the piano. Yeah, it's the piano kind of coming in.
4, 5, 1, 2.
Now that's different, this whistle.
Yeah.
We've got a whistly iwi.
What is an iwi?
An iwi is an electronic wind instrument.
Ah,
so it's as similar as a MIDI keyboard, but now you blow into it and you finger it like a woodwind instrument. It can really give you a sense of shape and real specificity.
There's 14 elements all told in this cue. This is interesting. The first time you hear the bass, it has a kind of a tremolo-y effect on it.
Right. Again, with, I think, a sense of quirkiness, a sense of Dory-ishness to that kind of wobble.
One other thing I wanted to point out was, on some of these tracks, there's one tiny little bit.
Yeah.
In the whole cue, here's these sort of these eighth notes at the end.
So that's kind of a prepared piano sound, so it gives a little bit of a funkiness, a thwackiness.
Yeah. Not only is it doing that, but it has an aquatic sonar quality to it.
Right, and I probably would not have instructed a player to say, I need something underwater. And it's kind of what you want a player to kind of bring. As opposed to saying, what's an underwater sound, which can oftentimes inhibit players from saying, well, gee, what does he even mean by that?
You right. know?
So oftentimes it's how do you draw ideas out of players that you never would think of on your own.
Wow.
And, you know, the theory being that everyone has this expressive capability and feels underexpressed in life.
Do you find that you find a certain amount of pieces and then start building on that for the whole blanket of the movie?
Uh-huh. A lot of times I'll ask Bill to take ideas and see where they work elsewhere.
Yeah.
To kind of unzip the preciousness of the composer by Bill dropping something in, there's less design or less obvious design.
Right, because it's found. We're the audience as well as the...
That's it.
The thing I can never get over is somewhere in before we've finished the last recording session, all the stuff that we've been searching and road testing and auditioning, suddenly it just becomes the identity of the movie.
You hope.
Yeah. And it has yet to not happen for me working with you, is that before the movie's wrapped, before it's even fully mixed, it feels like this inevitable element that, like, was always there, yet it wasn't. It always blows me away.